In this video, I'm going to show you two of my top editing techniques that I use in almost all of my portrait photos. Hi guys, my name is Eustace, and if you want to see more videos from me, please subscribe and smash that bell icon so that when I put up my next video, you will be notified. Let's do this. First technique, I'm going to show you how to add shine to your image and make your image pop. I'm going to add a new layer. I'm going to go down here. Then I'll go on my tools here and select the brush tool. I'll go on brushes here, and then I'm going to select the hard brush. I'll make the brush a little bit smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. I'll just paint like that. So I'll go on this layer. I'll just double click here, and then the layer style is going to pop up. I'm going to go on underlining layer here. I'm going to drag this triangle this side somewhere here, and then I'm going to alternate on the keyboard, and then I'm going to drag the other part of the triangle to break this triangle. I'm going to drag it this side. I'm going to let go somewhere here, and then I'm going to click OK. I'll go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. Just type 70 here, and then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to go to my brushes here and then select the soft round brush. I'll make the brush a little bit bigger, and then I'll just paint this part. I'll make the brush a little bit bigger again, and then I'll just paint this part. I'm going to paint even this part. I'm going to paint even this part like that. I'll reduce the opacity to 20%. This is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. I'm going to go to my tools here, and then I'm going to select the curvature pen tool. I'm going to go on my image. I'll make a point here, and then I'll make another point here. In the middle of this line, I'll make another point here, and then I'll drag it up like this. And then I'll just click here. I'll join this line. I'll click here to join it. And then I'll make another point here, and then I'll drag it out like this. I'm going to go inside my selection, right click, and then I'm going to select, make selection. So I'm going to use the radius of 1 and then click OK. I'm going to go on adjustment layer here, and then I'm going to select curves. Let me push it here. I'll make a point in the middle of the curve. I'll push it up so that I can brighten in this part. I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur. I'm going to use the radius of 100. Just going to type 100 here, and then I'm going to click OK. Let me close this. This is our before, this is our after. I'm going to make a point here, and then I'll make another point somewhere here. I'll make a point in the middle, and then I'll push it up. I'll just click here. I'll make a point here, and then I'll make a point in the middle, and then I'll drag it down like that. I'm going to go inside my selection, right click, and then I'm going to select, make selection. Radius 1, and then click OK. I'm going to go to adjustment layers here, and then I'm going to select the curves. I'm going to make a point in the middle of the curve. I'll drag it down like that. To make my selection darker, I'll drag it down, and then I'm going to go to filter, blur, and then I'll select the Gaussian blur. I'm going to use the radius of 100. I'm going to click OK. Let me close this. So this is our before, this is our after, this is our before, this is our after. So let me put these adjustments into a group. I'm going to select this curve. Then I'm going to Alt Shift on the keyboard. Then I'm going to select layer 1. Alt Control plus G on the keyboard to put them into a group. And then these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So if you feel like the effect is too much, you can just open the folder. You reduce the opacity of the curve like this. These are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to color grade the image. I'm going to go to adjustment layer, and then I'm going to select color lookup. I'm going to go to load 3D LUT. I'm going to select load 3D LUT. So I'm going to use my wedding LUT pack. I'll put the link in the description below if you're interested in my wedding LUT pack. I'm going to start with a champagne. So these are before, these are after. I'm going to reduce the opacity to 50%. So these are before, these are after. I'm going to go back to load 3D LUT. I'm going to select load 3D LUT. I'm going to use the crisp brown. So these are before, these are after. I'm going to go to load 3D LUT. And then I'm going to select load 3D LUT. Then I'm going to select the fountain. So this is our before, this is our after. I'm going to go back to load 3D LUT. Then I'm going to select maybe one tree. So it's our before, this is our after. I'm going to go back to load 3D LUT, then load 3D LUT, and then I'm going to select sticker. So this is our before, this is our after. I'm going to go back to load 3D LUT, load 3D LUT. I'm going to use the fountain for this photo. I'm going to use the fountain. I'm going to use this one. So this is our before, this is our after. I'm going to put these adjustments into a group. I'm going to select the color lookup. Then I'm going to Alt Shift, and then I'm going to select this folder. I'm going to Alt Control plus G on the keyboard to put these adjustments into a group. So these are before all the adjustments. These are after. These are before. These are after. If you feel like the effect is too much, you can just go back to these adjustments, and reduce the opacity. So in this other technique, I'm just going to show you how to make specific colors stand out more. So I'm going to go down here on this adjustment layer, and then I'm going to select selective color. I'm going to select the layer mask, and then I'm going to Alt Control plus I on the keyboard to invert the layer mask. I'm going to go on my tools, and then I'll select the brush tool. Since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set my foreground color to white. I can just click on this icon to switch between the foreground color and the background color. I can just press X on the keyboard. I'm going to make the brush a little bit bigger using the brackets on the keyboard, and then I'll just paint here. You can't see the effect because I haven't done anything to this adjustment layer. I'm just painting on the color that I want to change. So I want to change this color. I'll paint even this part. I want to change even this color. You can see here it's changing. I'll just paint like that. And then I'm going to double click on this icon. I'm going to go to colors here. I'll change from red to yellow, and then I'll just drag this. Only the places that I was painting are the places that are changing. I'm going to take it down like this. I'm going to change the colors to reds, and then I can make it like that. Can make it like that. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So this is the color that I want to target. The blues. So I'm going to go down on this adjustment layer. Then I'm going to select the selective color. I'm going to select the layer mask, and then I'm going to Alt Control plus I on the keyboard to invert it. And then I'm going to go to my tools, and then with the brush selected, I'm going to set the foreground color to white, and then I'll just paint here. You can't see the effect because I haven't changed the colors just yet. And then I'm going to paint even this part like that. You can see here it's changing. So make the brush a little bit smaller using the brackets on the keyboard. And then I'll just paint like that. And then I'm going to go on this icon. I'll just double click on it. And then I'm going to change from reds to blues. So I'm going to drag it this side. So you can see it's changing now. Then the magenta, change it to this. The yellows, I'll drag the yellows down to negative 100. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. Let me close this. These are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So this is the process. You can go ahead if you want, you can change this color. You can even change this other color here. So I'm going to put these adjustments into a group. So I'm going to select the color lookup tool, and then I'm going to Alt Control, and then I'm going to select the color lookup one. And then I'm going to Alt Control plus G on the keyboard to put them into a group like this. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to color grade the image. I'm going to go down on this adjustment layer, and then I'm going to select color lookup. And then I'm going to go to load 3D LUT, and then I'm going to select the load 3D LUT. This time I'm going to color grade this image using my vintage 2.0 LUT pack. So I'm going to select the code draw. If you feel like the effect is too much, just reduce the opacity to maybe 50%. So these are before, these are after. I'm going to go back to load 3D LUT. Then I'm going to select the load 3D LUT. And then I'm going to select the signature 7. So these are before, these are after. If you feel like the effect is too much, you can just reduce the opacity. So I'm going to go to load 3D LUT. Then I'm going to select the load 3D LUT. And then I'm going to select the EK1. Okay, let me close it. So these are before, These are after, these are before, these are after. I'm going to select the color lookup one. Then I'm going to Alt Shift. Then I'm going to select this group. And then I'm going to Alt Control plus G on the keyboard to put these adjustments into a group. Control G. And then this is our before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So if you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, check out my Retouching Actions Pack. The link will be in the description below. If you want to learn how to retouch using the frequency separation and the mixer brush, you should check this video on top. And if you want to learn how to retouch using my Retouching Actions Pack, you should check this video down here. I'll see you in the next one.